Gonna Be Friends by the White Stripes off of their third album, White Blood Cells. Speaking of which, my son just bought me White Blood Cells on vinyl. So now I have that to add to my collection. And in recognition of that, I want to do this song. First time I heard this song was at the beginning of Napoleon Dynamite. Maybe you too. So here we go. It's three chords for most of the song. One we'll add later. G, C, D. If you know those three chords, you can play a million and a half songs. So this is one of them. G, C, D. Later we'll add A. That'll be easy. So you can play those. You can strum them if you want to do that. If you don't want to learn how to pluck all the individual strings, you can just...
Ball is here, hear the yell. Back to school, ring the bell.
You can do that. You've learned the song, three chords, and like I say, there's that one A major we'll add in a little bit. So how the song is actually played though is through some finger picking. So let's start with this G. The pattern is this. So I'm going from the E string to the G string, back to the E. In fact, every series of chords, he keeps hitting as a bass note, the primary note of that chord. So he's hitting the G note, then he hits the C note, then he hits the D note. Okay, so every other finger pick is that bass note. So... E string, G string, E, B, E, G, E, B. So he follows a very similar pattern through the whole song doing that. At the very beginning of the song, he hits that open G string twice in a row. May have been intentional or maybe not, I don't know. Hits that open G twice. You don't have to worry about that if you're playing this song. Now on the C chord, it's almost the same with two little exceptions. Instead of hitting, he hits that root note, or I should say the bass note, every other time, and then he's alternating between those same two other strings, G and the B string, but he starts on the B string. The other change is the very last note, instead of going back to the G string, he stays on the B string. He just lifts up that index finger and hits the B string open. One more time. Then he goes back to the G. D. And then a partial C, but he keeps his finger on the B string third fret from that D. So you can see I lift all my fingers but my ring finger, put my middle finger on the third fret of the A string, which is the C note, and then just alternates between those two strings. So it goes like this from the D. Back to the G. So that's pretty much it. So there is one, actually two little exceptions to how he plays that G chord. Specifically between when he says the chorus, which is, I can tell we are gonna be friends. Then he goes back to that G for one bar. Then he goes back and says, I can tell we're going to be friends. Between those two times, he does alternate the G and B string that he's hitting open. So something like this. C, See, so I was hitting the B string first, the G string second, between that bass note there on the E string. He does that for the first two examples of the chorus. And then there's one other change that is a little bit different, and that is sometimes he keeps his ring finger on that third fret of the B string, which is a D note. And he'll leave that on there while he's playing the G chord. So here's me lifting my ring finger and playing a G chord. Here's me leaving my ring finger on that third fret of the B string, the D note. So he leaves that on there a few times throughout the song. My advice is this, don't worry about that. Sometimes leave it on, sometimes leave it off. If you're playing along with the song, you might want to know the pattern and when he does this and that. If you're playing the song, performing the song, don't worry about it. Worry about those chords and maybe just the basic rhythm of it. Make it your own a little bit. Like I was saying, you can play chords, you can kind of do something like that. But play it however you want. Know the chords, know the lyrics, sing the song, have fun. That's the purpose of music. So let's talk about the bridge now. That goes like this, same chords plus one.
We don't notice any time pass. We don't notice anything. We sit side by side in every class. Dad thinks that I sound funny, but she loves the way you sing. Tonight I'll dream while I'm in bed.
Back to the lyrics. So, you'll notice the G, C, D, and the A is added in there. So, all the G and C are the exact same as before. The A is just a little bit different, at least the way I hear it is different. And he's hitting that open A, and then he's hitting the second fret of the G string. And he does that while he's saying,
we sit side by side in every class.
That last little bit is, he hits the B string second fret, so part of that A major chord. And then he hits the B string open. And then goes into the C, does that one last time. And then on the D, I just hear him hitting the open D string. And I just strike up with my index finger over here on the bottom two strings, the E and the B. Now live, or if you want to, you can add a little lilt there. So I hit that bass note, the open D. So I just put my pinky on the third fret of the E string. Pull it off so that it's on the second fret, and then I just go down that each individual string till I get to the D. And then it goes back into,
tonight I'll dream while I'm in bed. Silly thoughts go through my head about the bugs and alphabet. When I wake tomorrow, I bet you and I will walk together again.
So not a terribly tough song. Like I say, three chords, well, four chords and some lyrics, and you can perform this song to whatever degree you would like. So over and out from my easy chair. Catch you next time.
Fall is here, hear the yell, back to school, ring the bell, brand new